When making a game, we often have many objects on the screen interacting with each other. Most objects are independent of each other, and their movements don't usually directly affect each other. But there are occasions when two separate objects may be connected, following each other around the layout. In those situations, Construct 2 has a behavior for us, called the pin behavior. The pin behavior positions an object at a relative distance and angle from another object, giving the impression that the second object is pinned to the first object. This can be useful in many situations, like ships flying in formation, a character's name following them, or like the example we'll be using here, a health bar following the player as they move around the layout. I have a layout here with a ship and health bar. The ship has the 8 direction and bound to layout behaviors applied, and that's it. What we want to do is add the pin behavior to the health bar, since that's the item we're pinning to the ship. The ship is controllable, so we want to pin any items to it, and not the other way around. The health bar is stationary, so if we pinned the ship to the health bar, the ship would be stuck. But when we pin the health bar to the ship, it follows along wherever the ship goes. Select the health bar, then click on Behaviors, Add New, and then select Pin under General. The pin behavior has no properties. It's all enabled within the event sheet. Before we switch over, I'll position the health bar to be near the ship, since the pin behavior will position the pinned object relative to its distance and angle from the object it's pinned to. In the event sheet, I have an event already set up that will fire off on the start of the layout. We need to add an action that pins the health bar to the ship. I'll click Add Action and select Health Bar. And under Pin, select Pin to Object. Now we can set some parameters which decide how the pin behavior will perform. For now, I'll leave everything set to default, but we need to specify which object the health bar should be pinned to, which is the ship. If we preview the layout, when I fly around the screen, the health bar is pinned to its position relative to the ship. By default, the pin behavior is set to keep the same relative position and angle. When using a health bar, we don't want the bar to change angle with the ship. It looks odd that way, so let's change it. I'll change the mode from position and angle to just position. You can also set it to angle so that it only alters the angle of the pin sprite. I'm not sure what a good use would be for that, but you can do it. If I preview the layout, you can see the health bar is pinned to the ship relative to the left wing. The next mode option is rope. Imagine there's an invisible rope tied to the pinned object, and it will be dragged behind the object it's pinned to. As you turn, the pinned object behaves the same way an item being pulled by a rope would behave. The last option, bar, is very similar to rope, but there's a small difference. For this example, imagine a small bar connected to the object. If you move forward, the object drags behind, just like with the rope option. But when you go back, the bar is solid, and the pinned item is kept at a fixed distance. When I switch back to rope, I travel forward and the health bar is pulled behind. But when I go back, the ship goes right over the health bar. The bar mode always keeps the object at a fixed distance from the object it's pinned to, while the rope mode drags the object only when it's at its maximum distance away from the object it's pinned to. The pin behavior can be very useful when using a health bar, like in this example, or when creating an RPG with a party that trails behind. You could create a game with a ship made up of multiple parts, which are pinned together. When the ship is destroyed, you could unpin them and give the effect of the ship falling apart into pieces. There are lots of possibilities, so make sure to get a good grasp on how the pin behavior works. Thanks for watching. If you found this content helpful, please consider supporting me on Patreon. Comment, like, and share this video, and subscribe for more tutorials. See you next time.